Everybody, what's going on? Jerome here along with Tootie, and today we have for you guys an awesome Pixelmon Go, Pokemon Go adventure. So what we decided to do is take our favorite game, Minecraft, and find a way to incorporate it into one of the coolest games out there right now, which is Pokemon Go. And what we came up with was this crazy minigame. So we put some shaders texture packs on our Pixelmon launchers, then we went from there and gave ourselves 30 Ultra Balls, one Master Ball, and a 10-minute timer on this awesome little island here. After that, we go hunting through the island, catching as many Pokemon as possible in 10 minutes, and then we have an epic battle, 6 versus 6. It's gonna be crazy. So, Tootie, keep in mind, we have two barriers this time. You have a time limit and a limited amount of balls. So it's gonna be interesting.
Okay. Yeah. So you have to plan, you have to strategize here, because if you waste all your Pokeballs and don't catch, you know, if you go for all the high levels and they break out of the Ultra Balls, you're in big trouble. So I feel like it's good to go for a nice, you know, mid-level range Pokemon.
Exactly. The strategies are going to be very different from what we're used to. But if you all enjoy this video and you want to see more, click that like button. I almost never set real like goals, but for this one, let's go for 10,000 likes. I'm being serious here. And if we can hit that, then we'll do plenty more of these Pixelmon Go, Pokemon Go series to come very soon. I'm very excited about this, Tootie. Super excited. So
it's gonna be fun.
If you're ready, dude, I'm going to get the timer out.
Oh,
and here we go.
Are we ready?
3, 2, 1. And go. There we
all
go.
Right.
10 minutes on the clock. I might go for a weird strategy because I feel like, well, if you find level 30s and 40s, you can't catch them with Ultra Balls off the bat. You know what I mean? So I think I might try and Master Ball level like 50 and then use them to catch the others.
There's so many Pokemans over here. A level 53 Peplar, a level 54 Peplar. They're all over the place, Jerome.
I know, but how are you going to catch level 50s? Oh, let's use the Master Ball first. You can do that.
You're right, but I don't know if I want to, actually, because I have this feeling. What if I find like a legendary?
I mean, the Pixelmon spawn rates on legendaries are so low. But if you did, I mean, kudos to you.
Yeah, yeah. Okay. Okay, there we go.
I use a Master Ball, to be honest with you.
Did you use the Master Ball? Oh, you got the level 54 Plepler. Oh,
yeah.
I made a big mistake.
No, I mean, it's not that big of a deal. I only did it for the one reason that, that I would like to, what's it called? I'd like to use them to catch other Pokemon. Because I feel like going up to level 40s or 30s, you're not going to be able to catch them at all unless they're injured first. So, like, this is my strat for that.
Whoa, that's... I didn't actually even think about that.
Yeah, dude. I went into this with a game plan.
I didn't... I'm so used to just catching Pokemon with Master Balls. I'm not... This is actually, like, having to play Pokemon. Whoa.
Oh, yeah. He keeps disabling my moves. It's making me very angry. Slowbo, stop wasting your time. You're going to get in my ball. You're going to be on my team regardless of if you want it or not. There we go. He's on the team, I think. I mean, I still have to catch him, but I'm assuming.
There's Slowbro's all over the place here. I'm just going to constantly fight Slowbro's.
Wow, he broke out. I mean, he has level 45, so it's not that crazy, but he has, like, no health left. He's in the red, and I always find it weird. Like, I feel like if Pokemon's in the red and you use an Ultra Ball, it should be very rare that they break out.
Yeah, that's fair. But you never know. Sometimes they just don't want it.
Oh, of course you never know. Oh, there we go though. I do know one thing. That's a captured Slowbro.
Oh, nice.
No way, 2D level 16 Wingles. Let go.
Wingles.
I'm playing.
That sounds like a really, really delicious, like.
You don't even know what Wingles Pelipper's first form.
I read the comments the other day on one of the Pixelmon videos, and I read the perfect comment the other day, and it said, 2D and Jerome are Gen 1ers. Do you know what that is?
Yeah, Generation 1 Pokemon.
Mm-hmm. That is me.
No, to be fair, I'll say this much. I'm definitely... Well, there's a mountain on this island. This is a big island. I mostly took it less seriously around Gen 3. So I played Gen 4 and beat all the Pokedex for that region, but I didn't really care as much because a lot of it I just did the global exchange and traded, but I was heavy, heavy Gen 3 downward, like really heavy Gen 3 downward.
I'm Gen 1. That's
the extent of it all?
Mm-hmm, that's it. That's about as far as my knowledge of Pokemon goes.
I don't know, dude. You're missing out. They've got some new mechanics in there. Oh my god, Kangaskhan's. They got some new mechanics in there that are pretty crazy. Okay, Scythers and Kangaskhan, so many options. I was only level 22 Scyther, we can wait. But you, Kangaskhan, you are the perfect addition to my squad. What are you doing hiding over here like this? Tootie, you died.
I done dead.
Why are you done deaded?
Because it's the fastest way to heal yourself. Jerome. And no, that my logic might not make much sense here, Jerome.
No, you're right. It actually is, though. It'll spawn you back at the healing area.
Right.
Smart.
Because someone murdered my slow bro.
Right, well, so, it's been 3.5 minutes, by the way, Tootie. So
three and a half
that
minutes.
Much.
Okay, okay. And you say we have 10 minutes, correct?
Yes, sir. 10 minutes. I'm kind of wondering if there's any point in catching anything weaker than a level 40.
That's, yeah, I don't know, because it's, yeah, I mean, I don't know. Is it?
Because they're also abundant, the high levels, but the problem is, are we going to be able to catch them?
That's the thing. Are you going to spend the time to capture really high-level Pokemon, or are you just going to go for a broader team with just a lot more lower-level Pokemon?
Well, while we're talking about that, this Kangaskhan is not sticking in this ball. I've wasted about 8 Pokeballs on him, but he's such a necessary part of this team.
Oh, I see you. Hi, Jerome. How are you doing?
Hey, Tootie. Okay, up until this Kangaskhan keeps breaking out. He's in the red, too. I have nothing to bring him down below the red. That's the worst feeling in the world.
What if I just came up and threw a Pokeball at him and caught him?
You somehow can't mid-battle. I'd be very upset, though.
That would be so funny. I wish that was a thing. Can this be a thing?
Oh, my God. I'm on my last Pokemon until Kangaskhan faints him. And it's a level 5, which means I'm going to be one-shotted if I don't catch this. Please, I'm going to be put on tilt. Ah, man. Wait, he tail-whipped. Okay, please. Please let me get this. I've wasted so much Ultra Balls and a decent amount of time. We're actually just about to pass the 5-minute mark now. Oh,
I believe in you, Jerome.
Oh, my God. I did it. I actually caught it with, like, the last attempt. Yes, there we go. Man, remember, everybody, if you're enjoying this and you want to see more, smash that like button. We're halfway through the catching phase, and this is so intense. Like, this is actually really cool.
What is that?
What is what?
It's a beaver.
A Bidoof?
No, it's I can't see its name because its name is actually in its head.
A timber?
I don't know. It looks like no. It's not a
Get him, Wild Tauros. I'm watching this Wild Tauros fight a Vulpix so that I can actually battle him. There we go. He won the battle, obviously.
Oh, this
is
good.
Oh my gosh. Dude, I can't wait to look at the Move Relearner's moves that he's got. He's probably got some crazy good ones in there.
Oh, this isn't good at all, Jerome. This Pokemon is wrecking me. He's wrecking my day. Please capture him. Please.
I'm getting a good range. I'm focusing on a Tauros level 44 right now.
Really? I'm actually focusing on a level 44 myself.
See, I like status effect ones a lot, though. Like, I like electric. I like things like a burn. I'm a big status effect player. I even put people to sleep, and I haven't gotten many of those. Like, I know Slowbro you could probably teach Yawn to with the Move Relearner, but other than that, though.
I think and my all-time favorite Pokemon would have to be Gengar.
Oh, of course, dude. Put him to sleep all the time. That's such a great... I love Gengar, too.
Gengar and Alakazam are my Pokemon. Scyther, why do you have such a strange hitbox? I've wasted 30 of my Ultra Balls, every single one of them, and they have all missed!
Hey, Tootie, I see you in the background there.
Oh, hey, Duder. How you doing?
Pretty good. I think I'm about to catch my status effector, because little known fact about Arbok, he gets all different types of elemental fang attacks. So he gets like Ice Fang, Thunder Fang, Fire Fang, and I think that's it. But that's still like, he hits across the elemental spectrum, which is pretty OP.
That is extremely good. Scyther, please, just get in the Pokeball. That's all I ask.
Is your team looking good, by the way? Or what's going on?
I don't want to talk about it, Jerome. I don't want to talk about it in the slightest sense.
Oh, I'm running low. We got 2 minutes and 35 seconds left. I'm running low on Ultra Balls, but I only need, after this Arbok, one more. There we go, caught Arbok. One more Pokemon I need.
Oh, no. Scyther, please!
I'm
going to
slash kill just to heal up one last time. Because,
okay, that's fair.
And do you want to do the tiebreaker rule? Where I don't know what the rule is. The buzzer beater rule, where if you're in a battle and the time is up, you can finish that to try and catch them.
Yeah, that's fair. That sounds fair to me.
All right, so it's like a final battle buzzer. Yes.
Yeah, that's always fun. Okay.
Is Lickitung any good?
I've never been a huge fan of him, to be fair. I mean, if he works for you, he works for you.
I just gotta find that one Pokemon that's worth my last like timer, like my buzzer beater, and that's it. No, you're not it.
I'm just
level
trying
20s.
To find a, you're not. Okay. How much time do we have left, by the way?
1 minute, 40 seconds.
Okay, 1 minute and 40 seconds.
This is intense, man. This is very, very intense.
This is extremely intense. Because I'm not having very good luck. So I just have to have a huge luck to be right at the end if I want to have
uh-oh.
Any uh-oh. Luck.
This is so bad, dude. Oh, Scyther's level 20 only? No. Go away, Scyther! Go away!
How much time do we have left?
We're good. No need to stretch. We got 1:10, but with the buzzer beater, we're good.
Right. I'm gonna try to get a Pokemon.
Is that?
Wait, as the...
A wild Nidoking?
What?
He's only level 32, though. I don't want him, but that's so cool. I don't realize you get a wild one.
Yeah, I think you can do that, right?
Yeah. By the way, I'm very glad this is a savanna biome.
Savanna biomes are the best.
Yeah. Because a lot, like, on an island, that works really well to get a savanna biome like this, for this. Because there's just a lot of high-level Pokemon you can find in there.
Mm-hmm. Savanna biome is definitely the best biome. At least it has my favorite type of Pokemon in it.
Well, not to scare you, but we have 30 seconds left. Man, this island is humongous.
Okay,
Hey, I found another Pokemon Center and a village.
Okay, bag, Pokeballs, please. I have 4 Ultra Balls left.
15 please. Seconds, please. And I have not found a single Pokemon to get in a fight with. I might lose my buzzer beater.
Okay, yeah, I captured him. Okay, I have 3 Pokeballs left. I'm so scared right now.
And time. Oh, man. So it looks like I'm going to be stuck with 5 Pokemon. I guess I could use Charmander, so I have 6. That's okay. Really rough. But it's okay, though, Tootie, because the real game comes around with the move Relearner, because that's where you get to teach him some crazy ones.
Yep. Oh,
so Pelipper, what you got here?
It's going to be a rough battle for me, Jerome. It's going to be a rough battle.
That's a pretty good one right there.
I'm going to heal my Pokemon up, and then I'm going to go learn some new moves.
That's a good one.
Okay, what do we got here?
Let's hit it with that one. And then... maybe we'll need this one, so we should probably just get it for the sake of getting it. All right, pretty good on that one. I've got some decent moves, that's for sure.
Okay, that's good.
And then, yeah, I'm gonna go with that one. Okay, I'm pretty happy with what I've got going. I've got 3 more to teach random things to, but 2-5 punch. Comet Punch isn't that good though. Comet Punch always sounds good, but.
It's really. Oh, whoops! My Squirtle isn't. Can I use my Squirtle?
Squirtle? Yeah. I'm using my Charmander. I don't know what for, but.
Cool. That's what I'll use.
That's super OP. I just got a super OP attack, Dizzy Punch.
That sounds like such a funny name, though. It's like Dizzy Punch. I don't know, it just sounds funny.
Nah, dude, you're crazy.
I'm crazy. All right.
And Arbok. There we go. My favorite moves. And Thunder Fang. And Fire Fang. Crunch, though, kills it as well. All right, I am all good to go then, Tootie.
All right, I'm ready when you are.
All right, so if I have to choose a Pokemon for you, I'm going to go ahead and choose number 3.
Ooh, okay. And for you, I'll choose a number 1.
Number 1. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Good thing I switched it up last second. That was my Charmander, but I switched him up right before that battle.
Ooh, this is...
Oh, level 27?
Yeah, he was kind of just one I caught last second.
Okay, fair enough. Well, you know... at least he did some damage in there.
Yeah, I was hoping that I might be able to paralyze you, but, you know... it didn't help me out in the slightest sense.
Okay, well, who's next on the list there, Tootie? Who's next? I'm so pumped, man. This is going to be such a fun final battle.
Let's go slow, bro.
Here we go. Oh, Crunchitize me, Captain.
Yawn.
We're going to put him to sleep. All right, Dizzy Punch. Please confuse him. Oh, that's bad. That's really bad news, Bears.
Yeah, that's huge.
Dang, there's nothing I can do because Kangaskhan's going to faint.
Mm-hmm.
I do have a strategy, though, to keep him alive. Go, Charmander!
Charmander had his...
It works!
No, you're not a very nice person.
The evil plan is working, Tootie.
Ooh, okay. I'm gonna go right at the start, and I'm gonna... Oh, that's good. Wait, I didn't... Why didn't I heal?
You use slack off. Are you thinking of rest, dude?
No, no, but I... No!
Dude!
No! No!
Dude!
No, 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 but it... But it... But it...
I think you got it wrong, bud.
I...
Oh, man, no. that is a rough... I gotta admit, too, that's pretty rough.
Okay.
Oh, you're going for the Arbok. Arbok's good, dude. Arbok's very good.
Thunder Fang.
Oh, my God. My guy's so dead this turn now.
Yeah, Thunder Fang's... Yeah.
Ooh. You got him beat.
How many Pokemon do you have left?
Four, but one of them's dead because it's Kangaskhan.
Okay, that's fair.
This will be an interesting one.
Ooh, this will be very interesting indeed. So let's
go with the good old Ice Fang.
Is Ice Fang what you're using? I'll go with Thunder Fang.
Wow, we both got all those elemental fang attacks.
Fire Fang.
There we go. I'm surprised the accuracy on those isn't 100, so I'm surprised neither of us really missed.
That is kind of funny how it...
Crunch, super effective to Psychic.
But why, dude?
But why, dude?
I just want to tell you that it's...
Remember, everybody, while you're clicking that like button, comment down below letting us know where you want us to do our next Pokemon Go battle. So we did an island this time. What's next on the list? We want to do in the mountains? I'm down wherever, Tootie.
The mountains? I say we do it underwater.
Okay. Well, hey, do you want to do a little bit of a fun battle here? And besides our starter types, pick our three worst Pokemon, as we always do. So for me, it'd be level 44s and 245s and battle it out in a three-thing battle.
All right. Yeah, that's fair to me.
So besides your starter, your worst three.
Okay. Yeah.
So man, that's rough. Arbok missed the cut by one level.
See, yeah, my Slowbro is out because he was 47 instead of 45. So, all right, Jerome.
Okay.
I picked number three. Number three.
All right. I'll pick number two. Three, right. Two, wow. One. Let's go. You picked Kangaskhan, but again, I moved him again.
I kicked Luxio!
No!
How is that possible?
What?
That is ridiculous.
Was that the same first battle, pretty much?
The exact same first battle.
That's actually hilarious. There's a Blaziken in the background. Oh my god.
Where is he?
He's behind the Pokemon Center, so you can't see him. Oh, there we go. Dude, I'm telling you, Dizzy Punch was the move and a half for me.
100%, 100%.
No way did I just learn. I just learned the craziest new move for Kangaskhan.
Oh, please, no.
Outrage. 120 attack damage. It's a dragon type move, too. GG, buddy.
What a stomp.
Oh, man. Well, that's going to do it, my friends. We hope you all enjoyed this awesome video. Remember that like goal of 10,000 likes. And apart from that, be sure to subscribe and join the Baka Slurping Army. We do modded Minecraft content every single day here. So what are you waiting for? Come hop along, join us, and have an awesome day. Thanks for watching, everybody.